Right before we jump into this video, if you'd like to take better pictures in only 11 days, I created a free mini video course that you can sign up for right now at froknowsphoto.com/11days. Jared Polin, froknowsphoto.com, and this video is a warning to Sony. I am making this video to help kick Sony in their ass before they squander the 5-year lead in mirrorless cameras as well as technology. I'm not making this because I now shoot Sony and want to always shoot with Sony, because personally, I'll shoot with whatever system allows me to get the job done and do what I do best. If that's Nikon or Canon or even something else, I'll use the best tool for the job. And right now, the best tool for that job is Sony. But, and this is a big but, Canon is on the move. This past week, Canon finally announced their pro mirrorless camera in the EOS R5, which is poised to be this generation's 5D. On top of that, they just released the 1DX Mark III, which for all intent and purposes is a DSLR masquerading as a mirrorless camera. I've been saying it for over a year now. I honestly think Canon is the sleeper in this race right now. A lot of people have been saying Canon is dying, but Canon is huge, and they're making a massive investment in the glass, and then they're gonna get the pro bodies, and people are gonna stick with their Canons. And that prediction is starting to come true. So where do the potential issues lie with Sony? First, let's start with the body design. Sony has a tendency to want to shrink everything that they make. They want smaller, more compact components, which leads to bodies that are less rugged feeling compared to their competitors. It also means they stick with SD cards, which still in my mind is not the right card for professionals. Sure, the new Sony tough cards feel better, but that doesn't change the speed at which they read and write. Sony has taken steps to make a larger, better feeling body with the A7 R4 and the A9 II, but they still need to do more. They need to go bigger to allow CF Express cards. These cards are blazing fast and will solve some of the issues I have when taking quick bursts with the A9 II. In the year 2020, I should not have to wait for files to write to SD cards from the buffer. Hell, Sony invented the XQD card format, which is faster, yet they never implemented it into their consumer or pro level cameras. Nikon adopted the XQD card for their Z6 and Z7, and you're never outrunning the buffer or waiting for the files to write to the card. If Sony chooses to fight to keep pro cameras more compact in favor of size versus durability, weather sealing, and faster media, pros might start to look somewhere else. The mount. Is the size of the Sony mount an issue? Well, according to some, the answer is yes, and according to Sony, the answer is no. But my question is, why did Nikon and Canon opt for a new larger mount opposed to sticking with the same mount that was inherited more than a decade ago from Minolta? We've seen Canon crushing the lens game with their RF lineup. Nikon, on the other hand, has been a little slower to release their pro lenses, but there are plenty of them on the way and they are super solid. Now, can Sony go to a bigger mount at this point, or should they? The first answer is, I'm sure they could, but it would be really bad for business and a major step backwards. The second answer in terms of should they is probably no. They have a large selection of native E-mount lenses that are fantastic in terms of quality, and they're also super fast in terms of focusing. But they are not unique in the same way that RF glass is unique. Canon's hit us with an F2 zoom, a full Hebrew trinity of lenses, and even a bunch of 1.2 primes. And they don't even have a pro mirrorless body at this point. Sony, on the other hand, has stuck with more of the status quo lineup, and there's nothing wrong with that right now. But maybe in the future, they won't be able to do the innovative things that Canon is doing with their lenses. IAF is the main reason I switched from Nikon to Sony. And as commenters keep telling me, I am being unfair to Nikon. Now they keep missing the points I've been saying. I prefer the way Nikon files look and handle over Sony's. But I cannot deal with one card slot, no grip, slow moving AF points, and not reliable IAF. On the flip side, I 100% trust and rely on Sony's IAF, especially in the environments I've been finding myself in, on the campaign trail as well as off. The fact that I can acquire the subject almost instantly, no matter where they are in the frame, and then still be able to have the focus lock on them while I compose and shoot, now that's revolutionary. I've been able to react and capture shots that I otherwise would not have been able to capture with a Nikon or a Canon. But guess what? Canon's IAF is improving faster than Nikon's and becoming more and more reliable with every single update. The 1DX Mark III is a DSLR, but Canon seems to be touting all of the mirrorless features that it offers. Canon is basically tipping their hand for what you can expect to see when they finally release their pro mirrorless bodies. Canon has said it themselves. They were late to the mirrorless game, and 2020 is the year that they play catch up. The combination of RF glass pro mirrorless bodies and their version of IAF with lock-on tracking is exactly why I'm sending out this warning to Sony. Now, I've personally never shot Canon professionally. Now, of course, I've reviewed plenty of their cameras, but at the rate that they're going, I see no reason why in the not too distant future that I might be able to shoot them professionally full time. Let me cut in here real quick and let you know that the image that you're seeing on the screen right now was taken with a Sony camera and edited using FroPak 2. If you're looking to speed up your RAW workflow or give yourself a great starting point, we created 15 all-new custom Lightroom presets that you can check out right now at froknowsphoto.com/FroPak2. Over there, you can play with the sliders to see the befores and the afters, and if you decide to pick them up right now, they are currently on sale for 40% off. Or if you'd like to pick up FroPak 1 and FroPak 2 as a bundle, you can save even more. Now, let's get back to the video. Here's what I think Sony needs to do to keep their lead. Above, I said bigger bodies that allow CF Express cards, but they also need to work on their lens lineup once again. Their 70-200 2.8 is the heaviest 70-200 2.8 that I've ever used. Canon shrunk theirs, and I'm hoping that Sony follows the lead and shrinks theirs as well. They don't offer a lot of high-end pro G Master glass for the pros. Now, they haven't pushed the envelope of their lenses like Canon has with the RF, but on the flip side, you can get a whole lineup of Sigma Art lenses, including one of my all-time favorites, the 35-1.2. Could this be Sony's plan? Build bodies and sensors and let other companies push the lens lineup forward? I'd like to see the next A9 III push the limits of quality. Now, I don't need 36 megapixels at 20 frames per second. Now, I wouldn't kick it out of bed if it did offer that, but I much prefer having less megapixels, but a much cleaner, higher ISO capability. The Canon 1DX Mark III claims its new 12,800 is like 6,400 in the Mark II. I'm not saying I want to shoot at super high ISOs, because if you really need to push super high, you're probably already shooting in the dark. What I want are cleaner shots at 4,000 to 6,400 ISO. I want the faster cards, and I want the continued improvement of lock-on tracking AF. It's not always perfect, but as I've said before, I've been able to capture more shots I otherwise would have never gotten with traditional focusing systems than shots that I've missed because tracking failed. Basically, what I'm looking for are Nikon quality files, except in a Sony body. Now, I know I didn't dive into video at all in this entire video because I wanted to focus on the stills aspect. At the end of the day, Sony in my mind is still well in the lead. They offer three super solid bodies that don't skimp out on any features. You still find IAF across the board along with silent shooting. Sony is still king of the hill. But if they're not careful and don't continue to innovate, they run the risk of allowing Canon, Nikon, or someone else to gain momentum. Jared Polin, froknowsphoto.com. See ya.